things his press officers say about him. But I wonder how Jean-Michel Jarre feels to have his 1981 album Magnetic Fields described as the music of the planetary village. In fact, I'm going to ask him in a minute, but first, this is the music. Jean-Michel Jarre and Magnetic Fields. Jean-Michel, music for the planetary village. Is that the kind of thing people tend to say about instrumental music?
I don't know, but you must not believe all these things written by... I don't know who, actually.
do you find being instrumental an advantage or a disadvantage? Do you often wish you could sing or would sing?
I think I'm trying to think about the lyrics for the next few years. So I make the playback first. And I'm hoping to have the inspiration for the right lyrics in the future.
No,
I'm joking. I think for me, songs with lyrics or without lyrics are not particularly different. I mean, on a French point of view, maybe it's easier when you have no local lyrics.
Mm-hmm. I'm intrigued by your last LP, Music for Supermarkets, which I understand there was only one copy pressed of. Why?
Yes, I think I could answer you that you know, we have a big crisis in France, so we have no
Don't
more record shop. So that was quite an easy way, and I found a buyer, and it was a foreigner actually.
You made one record,
yes.
And you pressed one copy, and you auctioned it off. Is this correct?
No, that's right. It was for the idea was coming from the fact of a lot of young artists, painters, and sculptors. We are doing a lot of big exhibition about supermarkets, objects redesigned, retransformed in sculpture and paintings. And the idea was to do to help them to make a spot in France on their work. And I composed the music for the gallery. And we had the idea of sending the record as a sort of painting. As a single copy.
So there was one copy, and then you destroyed the lacquer and the tapes
right.
And things like that afterwards.
And the record company was not particularly happy about it. As
I just wonder where you stand with regard to royalties on a record that there's only one copy of.
I'm hoping for the new one.
Now let's talk about that one, Zuluk, which features people like Laurie Anderson on vocals and Adrian Belew, who was previously with the Talking Heads.
Yes, that's right.
What are you seeking to achieve with this record? The first thing that strikes you when you look at the sleeve is all the different languages on it.
Yes, I traveled quite a lot and I collected a lot of different foreign sounds, transformed through Fairlight and all different synthesizers. And so it's maybe my first vocal LP in a way.
Now, I understand you're actually planning to tour with this record. You've never toured before at all.
I toured in different countries, never in England, and it will be hopefully for this year, yes. I'm preparing a world tour, but with open-air concerts, a lot of different countries, in about 8 months, actually.
And you're hoping to get people like Laurie Anderson on that tour, are you? Is that
Yes, you should ask her. I think so.
I will if I bump into her. I don't think it's likely to happen. Thanks very much, Jean-Michel Jarre. And we'll just finish with a track from Jean-Michel's latest album, just a brief extract, accompanied by some visuals we've knocked together. This is the single, and it's called Zuluk.